Hey, Andrew.
Trevor, right? You review movies for that kids online newsletter thing?
It's a professional podcast with a lens towards youth learning and film education.
Anyway, thank you for promoting our cinema on your thing. Are you here for the private screening?
Oh, yeah. I'm just waiting for my editor-in-chief to drop off supplies.
Editor-in-chief?
My mom.
And supplies?
My retainer.
Copy that.
Scraped all the gum from Theater 5.
Why the mask?
I was afraid I'd bang my head.
And the coveralls?
Protection, in case I spilt the red slushy that I brought with me.
And why the slushy? You know what? Forget it. Good job. Go clean up.
I made all of the gum into a chewy bouncy ball. Can I keep it?
Sure.
Oh, sweet!
You're a bit of a horror show yourself sometimes, aren't you?
You really mean that?
I really mean that.
That's what my dad said on my birthday card. Thanks, man.
Wow.
Your grandmother's tarot cards are beautiful, Jordan.
My mom says we come from a long line of dog walkers, ice fishers, and Romanis.
And you're not superstitious about them?
No. I once played Go Fish with my uncle, and he went bald overnight. But tarot cards aren't that bad. Not even in the movies.
Tarot cards were in Dead Alive, Stephen King's Thinner, Lord of Illusions, and...
Space Jam.
Space Jam?
Now Ouija boards. Those are frightening.
Not at all. I remember a sleepover when I was a little girl. My friends and I used one. And then there was a fire. Hmm. And then I was on the lawn, watching the house burn. I love the smell of barbecue.
Hmm. Hey, gang. So, Gina, our party person, is sick. I need a volunteer for the overnight movie camp tonight.
We were just talking about sleepovers. Can I do it? Can I bring the tarot cards?
I was actually gonna ask Isabel. She's really good at party planning.
She left. Homework due tomorrow.
Boss man asked me to take the rest of her shift.
I love mentoring children. Is there a Ouija board? Can we check the lost and found?
Well, maybe Jordan?
Sure.
But...
Wait, does this mean I get to stay overnight here?
It's kind of the point of a sleepover camp.
No, wait. I have to be a part of the cleanup crew again tonight.
Okay, I'll take care of the cleaning. Just make sure the children have a good time.
Cool.
Jordan, is this a toaster strudel in with your tarot cards?
Oh, sweet!
That looks stale.
Why are you still eating it?
Mima told me to never waste food.
Okay, but Jordan, don't eat it if it's gonna make you sick.
Mima, my Mima, told me to never
waste food.
Ah, Andrew, there you are.
Where else would I be?
Well, several places, actually. Your office, the box office, a projections booth, theater.
Hiding behind a curtain ready to pounce, perhaps?
Although I am glad I did not find you there. That would be a bit strange.
Yeah.
So you were looking for me? Right. There was a box of electronics that I left on your workbench. I need it back.
Oh, I used a couple of the circuit boards to fix the claw machine.
That should not be a problem. I need to return what we do have to my tech group. There were some issues.
Troubles at the lab?
Stay calm, Andrew. Your small financial investment in Darvis Robotics is perfectly safe.
So long as we keep discovering, capturing, and burning the units that become self-aware and angry. Homicidal, even.
I thought you were building interactive teddy bears.
Yes. However, some are more aggressively interactive than we would like.
Aggressive?
Not to worry. They have been destroyed. I think the smell of their burning fur will linger longer than their tiny cries of,
"Please love me,"
as they melted into slag.
Just bad programming, I suppose.
Let's go find that box.
Lead the way.
So Jordan will be covering the party when it arrives, which means I will be on cleaning duty, so I will not be available immediately. So I'm really counting on you guys to pull it together because we'll be busy tonight with the new horror film that opened up yesterday.
In a world where lactose causes more than just intolerance, all she wanted was a late night snack. But the night held a dark fate in that cheese plate. Can you stomach the intense experience that will leave you wondering?
Just one more piece.
What possessed you?
Starting this weekend.
Okay, let's make Andrew proud tonight. Test, test, this is Rebecca the cleaner reporting for duty.
She's the cleaner? Time to start a real horror show at 7:06.
I say hello to the claw. Feed me some spare change and use my claw to help your child get a gift they'll love.
You talking to me?
Play the claw, it's only a buck.
I'll have that one.
Marks. Now pick your gift.
It's not about winning, it's about playing. Still, like, pay good money.
Ouch!
I have a job to do. Where I'm going, you can't follow.
Try again! It's only a buck!
You called, boss?
Yeah. Saw you on the cameras. Why are you cleaning?
I had to make a decision. Isabel wasn't able to make the party, so I chose Jordan over Sunny, but Jordan was on cleaning crew.
Becky, so I decided... You're a manager now.
Yeah.
It means you manage your staff. They don't manage you.
You know, Sunny had never cleaned a day in her life, and I didn't know about the rest of the staff.
Just keep in mind for the future, you manage the staff, all right? Leave the details of the exhausting, dirty work, leave it to them.
Right.
Still, that was a really good call getting Jordan to the party instead of Sunny.
If you ask me, that car company should be making more rom-coms about Halloween instead of Christmas. What a cute baby. I bet he tastes as good as he smells. Mm-hmm. He does.
You're really packing on the popcorn, aren't you?
Yeah.
Excuse me? Your name tag's upside down. Sunny. Have some pride in yourself.
Okay, Theater 3 is almost out. I gotta go.
Hey, most of our overnight guests have arrived.
Great, have fun. Whenever you finish dinner in the party room, everything will be all set up for you in Theater 3.
Yeah.
Problem?
parents are asking about food choices?
It was on the sign-up form. Pizza, popcorn, hot dogs.
They want healthier options.
I'm gonna need you to get to the point here, Jordan.
Okay. Some of the kids brought food from home. And I know our policy on that.
That's okay, we can overlook that tonight.
They brought full plates of ants on a log.
Which is?
Celery, cheese, raisins.
Repulsive zombie fruit. Some people just don't care about their children, do they? I mean, the crap, they force feed them.
What contest did you say I won?
Special one, our best contest yet. All the candy you can eat. More finished trout gummies?
Uh-huh.
Then after that, you get to see a movie with me. Wouldn't that be fun?
It's so pretty.
Oh, I love guys with a healthy appetite.
I don't think I feel well.
He's ready.
You're gonna love this movie. Oh yeah, it's a good movie.
Feed me some spare change and use my claw to help your child get a gift they'll love.
Here, come on. Here we go. Oh, no. Wrong way. There you go. Go with her.
Good luck on your date, you two.
You're not coming with us?
Well, this was your idea, and I want you to enjoy your success or failure. Besides, you're going to need me to be here to drive off after it all goes down or comes up.
Thank you, sir.
It's called mentoring. You're welcome. Oh, your hat.
Oh, yes.
Can't get that. Oh, thanks so much. Make sure you get him a lot of candy.
Hey, let's go.
Mm-hmm. Why are you here? I'm causing trouble for Cinema 6, ma'am.
Do you think it's wise for you to be seen here?
I sent my subordinate in. You?
Against my better judgment, doing some reconnaissance. I've been checking the interior structure against these old plans.
And?
It's perfect for my project.
After we sink this place, MegaFilmPlex will be the only movie theater for people to watch movies. It's gonna be amazing.
Not my concern. Look, I better go before anyone recognizes me. And forbid the thought we're seeing together.
No problem with that, Mayor.
I'm just not feeling. Are we at a different movie theater?
Here, I'm just gonna go use the bathroom. Why don't you go get us some snacks? Hmm?
I think I'm gonna.
Oh, but I just want some popcorn and some drinks. Pretty, please.
You're so pretty. It's so nice.
Mm.
I feel like I could just let myself go with you.
Yes, let everything go. All of it. Everything. Let it all out inside the theater, huh?
whoa!
Help. Come play. Feed me a child.
It's okay. I'll take care of it. Just go to the snack bar and ask if they can replace your drink.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's okay. Oh.
Come on!
Need a clean up in theater number
This is Rebecca. Please repeat.
Can we get some help in theater number 6?
Where are you?
I am in cinema 6. Do you copy? Does anyone copy?
Wait, where in cinema 6?
Hello?
I heard there was a spill in front of theater 2.
I'm on it.
Hey, did you hear anything else on this channel?
Just you? Why?
No reason. I guess I must be imagining things.
Have you been using Dumpster Fresh to clean?
Yes.
Don't inhale the fumes.
Roger that.
Jordan. Missing something?
No. Not at all.
Have you checked the children?
They are safe. Together. In one place.
Shouldn't you be with them then?
Of course. But have you seen someone? Yay tall? Riding a big wheel? Maybe.
No.
All right.
Should I help him find the child?
No,
I need you covering the snack bar for the rush before the new movie.
The worst horror starts from within. Even if you find it hard to digest.
Just one more piece.
In those moments you are bored and seek ease, beware of a board that has cheese. You'll keep asking yourself, what possessed you?
Starring multi-award winner Jessica Fontaine.
Pre-sales are pretty high, and I'm betting the snack bar is going to explode, so if you could...
Let's see you survive this night, Cinema 6.
Hey there.
Are you okay? You look a little down.
I'm waiting for my date.
Oh. Okay, well, I can help you with that. What's her name?
Ralph.
Oh, sorry, I'm tired. I didn't mean to assume. Okay, his name is Ralph. Are you supposed to meet him here at the theater, or?
Her.
Are you sure you're okay?
That was oddly specific.
Oh, is Rebecca on it?
Oh, she's all over it.
All right, well, when she's done, send her to the women's washroom. Something's gone wrong with the plumbing.
Roger.
No. Ralph.
How'd it go?
You know, exploding toilets, and from what I heard, everything went off as planned.
Excellent! We should get out of here. You know, keep up this forward thinking and I might just maybe eventually make you Employee of the Month. Eventually.
Thank you, sir.
You're bright. And you know your place in the pecking order.
Do you smell something? Do or do not. There is no try.
Feed me. Feed me a child. Size matters not.
Sweet, a free prize. A shoe?
Yes.
What?
Yes.
Mr. Darvis, a funny clown machine.
Funny peculiar or funny haha?
A little bit of both, I think.
You speak?
I hunger too.
Yeah, and the prizes are lame.
Oh, absolutely horrifying.
And I do not just mean your grabber.
Oh, good evening, sir.
Hello, Ms. Keener. I love what you've done with your look. Quite for the gram, as they say.
Keep it together. This will all be over soon.
Oh, come on!
Andrew, there you are.
Where else would I be?
Well, you could be in the snack bar.
As much as I love our little game, we have a much larger problem at hand.
Well, at any point, one of 2,000 problems.
This is more immediate.
Oh, like a young man vomiting in the lobby?
No.
A child on a big wheel knocking over guests?
No.
Ancient plumbing in the woman's washroom exploding and spewing sewage over half the stalls?
No. I mean, Andrew, please. I do not have time for these completely imaginary scenarios.
Yeah. Imaginary.
I appreciate you trying to entertain me, but this is serious.
Okay. Wow, I've never seen you this upset. What's eating you?
Not eating me. However...
Serve me. Bring me a child to claw.
Huh.
Well, I'll say this. That is not something you expect to hear from a prize machine.
Feed me.
I believe one of the boards that you used
was... You will serve.
Excuse me, I was talking.
I'm sorry, Mr. Darvis.
I believe he's self-aware.
Yeah.
I don't actually identify as the earthly concept
All
of
right,
gender.
All right, quiet you.
I'll replace the circuit board ASAP.
I prefer as soon as possible.
You're the boss.
Honestly, gentlemen. I have not yet had enough nourishment for the day. Could you please bring me some more children? Perhaps a sandwich? Maybe some raisins?
And that's that. It wouldn't hurt just to rest my feet. Oh, for a little bit. Oh, yeah.
Look, Andrew. I can see you're pretty upset about this. I honestly think you should sit down, take a stress pill, and think things over.
Well, there's nothing to think about. I have no feelings about this, one way or the other.
I'm afraid, Andrew. Andrew, my mind is going. I can feel it. My mind is going. No question about it. I can feel it.
Shh. It's time to sleep now, crazy claw machine.
Will I dream, Andrew?
I doubt it. You're a claw machine. What would you even dream about?
I hear music, Andrew. Would you like me to sing it to you?
Not really.
Daisy... Daisy, give me your answer true. I'm half crazy, all for the love of you. It won't be a stylish marriage. I can.
Problem 2001 solved.
Thank you.
You were a good claw machine. Except for that whole attacking children thing. That was kind of lame, but you were cool other than that.
Ooh. And boom! Huh. That's weird. This card again.
It's scary. I don't like it.
Well, it's okay. As long as I'm here, you're protected. Oh, a strudel isn't sitting very well. I shouldn't have also had that spray cheese and raisins. Oh boy. I'll be right back. Oh no.
Uh-oh.
Where am I? Right, still at Cinema 6. My throat. I can't speak. Why are those kids alone? Where's Jordan?
Children. It's where's Jordan? Get.
Robe.
Awesome found.
Makes sense. What's the rush?
Need to get rid of some raisins.
Don't let me stop you.
Raisins.
Good night, crazy clown machine.
Perfect. Okay, you want a piece of me, George? You picked the wrong day. Yeah, darn right, you best step off.